BSB, period, nigga.
Troy Ave. Bricks in the backpack.
YLB, Hov Van Hilton, Dan the Life. We got a late start to the day, kind of. The rainy day. About to go get with the homie Sycamore. We got some business to work out. And after we do that, we got to get with the homie Hov. We got some more business to work out. And then after that, I got to get with Troy Ave. Let's go over these records. We got Bricks in My Backpack Part 2 coming. So the shit don't ever stop, man. Shit don't ever stop. There's always something to do. There's always a plan to be reworked, rethought of, something different to be executed, because you gotta be able to roll with adversity. Because you could plan for a sunny day, but it might rain. What do? You don't do it? Nah, you do it. You just figure, let's get the ponchos. Like, Sycamore been my nigga for years. Like, I always had an admiration for what he was doing, him being a young nigga, and him being from Brooklyn, and him having his own business and his own brand and shit. Like, that shit was just crazy. I just bumped into him, and I found out through a mutual friend, my son Gutter. What's up, Crip? What's up, Gutter? Through a mutual acquaintance, that admiration was mutual, because he felt what we was doing, he always wanted to know, like, you know, who was behind this whole Troy Ave shit. And me and him started kicking it, or whatever, no Mr. C. We started kicking it and sharing ideas and shit, and it turned into me and him working together. Like, he had a company,
it was called Be Famous Firm, Maine,
where he had, like,
Famous Firm and shit,
and do shows. Like, me and Sick had a whole series of 4 to 5 concerts that we did in Brooklyn. We had everybody, Currency, we had Currency twice, Smoke Dizza, Nipsey, Troy Ave, Push Montana, Dickie Simmons, Joel, Big Crit, before anybody knew who Big Crit was like that, Dom Kennedy, Dickie, we had just about everybody. We did it right in Brooklyn or whatever. So that's one avenue where me and him do business together, besides him being like a business partner and shit like that. That's also one of my daughter's godfathers. So, like, you know, that's not just my homeboy, that's my nigga. Like, we fucks with each other. Besides, if it was no music, if we didn't do music shit together, we was just getting money together. That's my nigga forever. He gave me an opportunity and he introduced me to some great people. Joey IE, that's my big homie, that's his big homie. Hip hop, that's his big homie, that's my big homie.
I let you into my diary to admire me. The makeup of this man, I let you see the high of me. The self-righteous drug dealer dichotomy. I'm drawn from both sides, I am Siamese. The tug of war opens the door in Trotter. Rip me apart and see what's inside of this pinata. Enrolling kilos in Jim Strata, that's one saga. One chapter of black magic, I'm Harold Potter. Feels like I'm doomed to dealing with women who relationships with their fathers won't allow us to bloom and blossom. I swear them Vegas nights was fucking awesome, but adios, I blow my own.
Famous Firm, you know, started with a vision to do artist development, and we had a really great first year. Can we get that on tape? Show, you know, you've really been in it for a long time, so tell me about how you started.
I really started with doing music, managing, A&R-ing. We started going out selling CDs together, then that kind of grew into me A&R-ing his music and like, ah, let's do it like this, let's get this on, let's kind of go in this direction with it. And then from me A&R-ing, the first CD that I A&R, which was Major Without a Deal, that caused him to get his record deal with Butch Lewis and Def Jam. So the people up at Butch Lewis was like, yo, who's like the person behind the music? Like, I know you're not doing this by yourself, like you're recording it, but who's behind the music? And he was like, yo, it's my man Hov Van, who really kind of like does everything as far as musically for me or whatever. So after he did that, or whatever the case may be, that led me to my first job. Butch Lewis put me on the payroll, and I was the head A&R of their Voices Music Group, which was had a subdivision through Def Jam, a subsidy through Def Jam. So that was my first on the books
job. Really, to be honest, yeah, that was my first job was a job in music. So from the Butch Lewis situation, still working with Troy or whatever, Butch showing us the ropes of just business per se, not music business, just business. And the situation over there with Troy didn't work out to our liking or whatever, so he gave us our blessing, let us go on our way, and then that's how I got my start really in music. It was kind of like a paid internship.
People tell you they don't like how you doing something, or you're a bad look for this. A bad look is better than no look. That's what niggas is, no looks. They lifetime commentators. They tell you, sit around and tell you about what you should do, what you shouldn't do, who's doing this, who got the most money. But one thing people that always tell you about what somebody got and what somebody don't got, they never tell you what they have, because they usually don't have nothing. Because when you're a real nigga and you got a lot of shit going on, you don't got time to be thinking about nobody else. When I woke up this morning and jumped in the shower, I wasn't thinking about what nobody else was doing. I said, damn, what I have to do for the day. I called my assistant, see what I gotta do. Washed my ass, got dressed, changed my door to pamper, and hit the door and do what I gotta do.
Joan and lemonade, we call that creative juice.
It's not like
juice.
Other niggas' money. Like us.
3,500 cash paid all in 20. Max doing business with you, even though you're funny. Right. My nigga Hov say he don't really like the boy. Next time he buy work, we might.
Powder. Uh-huh. This is for the G's and this is for the hustlers. Celebrating life, getting money, motherfucker.
So if you're getting it, or I'm getting it, so if niggas aspire to get it, then they need to listen to my music, because that'll help you get it. Now, on the other hand, if you just want to get a job, you want to work at Popeye's, right there, you want to work at Popeye's.
That's what you want to do.
Listen to them other niggas shit.
Listen to them other niggas. If that's what you want to do,
niggas
listen to them
about
niggas.
The stars and the trees and mythology.
Yeah.
You got a body, Hollywood.
Do that fuck shit. If you wanna work at a motherfucking car wash, that's what you wanna do. You know, you listen to them other niggas. But if you wanna get bitches, money, jewelry, and you need to fuck with this thing we got going on over here. BSB, Big Star Boys, Brick Star Boys, Harry Powder, Bricks in My Backpack, The Secret. Like, it's what you want to do, man. Like Tupac, if you want to come to death row and get money, like, everything you talk about, we aspire that. But if you don't have those type of dreams and aspirations in life, don't fuck with me.
So that's it, YRB Magazine. Day in the Life. Old Man Hilton. So what it was, so what it is. Started in Brownfield, Brooklyn, Grand Hills, Lower East Side, Midtown, back to Bushwick. It's not no typical day, every day is different. What you think?
Gymnastics, I somersault bricks, black talent start flying. When a nigga flip, I cook crack in the microwave. Niggas can't fuck with me, man, my codies. Call me Chef Boy, y'all 50, check my logic. Smokers don't like seasoning, we ain't shit. Send me them seeds, I grown what they need. They make chia pet plants in the crib, that's chronic. And I'm selling them.